When a data source powers your app, you can continuously update your app contents without having to republish it. It allows you to build a dynamic app that can create, read, update, and delete data. We'll cover those actions in other tutorials. For now, let's connect our project to Webflow as the data source. To add a data source to your project, click the data icon in the far left to access your data source library, and then click the plus sign at the top of the panel. You can select from previously added data sources or add a new data source. There are four data source options: create your own table, or integrations with Airtable, Google Sheets, and Webflow. We'll connect to Webflow. Check out our other tutorials to learn about the other data source options.
To connect your Webflow site to your Thunkable project, you can either use an API key or OAuth. We'll take a look at each.
When using Webflow as the data source for your Thunkable app, you'll connect to a Webflow CMS or Content Management System collection.
Let's start with the API key integration option.
Within the Webflow platform, navigate to your site settings, click the Integrations tab, and click to generate an API token. Copy the Webflow API token and paste it into the corresponding field in Thunkable. Click Refresh to see a list of your Webflow sites. Select the site you want to use as your data source and click Create.
Now, let's take a quick look at the OAuth integration option. Click Connect to Webflow. On the Webflow authorization screen that opens, select the sites or workspaces you want to authorize access to, and then click Authorize App. Select the site you want to use as your data source and click Create.
Now, to supercharge your app with the data, click the Designer icon to build your app's user interface. In the Components library, there are two data viewer components, the list and the grid. Each of these acts as a presentation layer for the data source. We'll opt for the list. Drag and drop the Data Viewer List component onto your screen and resize it. In the Data Viewer's Properties panel, select your Webflow data source from the dropdown. If your Webflow CMS has multiple collections, ensure that the correct one is selected. Click where you see the words title and subtitle to select the design layout for how you'd like your data displayed. Let's stick with the one with the title and subtitle. Now to map the spreadsheet columns to fields in the Data Viewer's List template. To do this, click in each field associated with your chosen layout and select from the drop-down of your column headers. Let's check it out on our device with the Thunkable Live app. And when we update the data in Webflow, it will update in our app automatically. Data sources for the win.
Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to check out our other tutorials and Thunkable Academy courses.
And remember, if you can think it, you can thunk it.